Anita Ray and Patrick Agunza on the Hot Drive.
We have Guardian Angel Studio. Karibu sana.
Shukuru.
I think this is the third time I'm hosting you. Yeah, I think it's the third time I'm hosting you. Yes, and for me it's always a pleasure. And we're going to start with quite the story in Rako Kwambia. When we walk up with your two and someone gave me that story, I have not laughed that much. Because my host gave me your story and the way you explained mbona hukutoa video ya ingoma yako mpya, and I was like, information goes fast, very fast. So tell us, you had a new video. This song is with DK.
Yeah.
And you had a video that DK was supposed to be featured. Mm-hmm. Then what happened?
Us guys had to reshoot the video.
Mm-hmm. You had already shot a whole video.
Yeah, us guys had a video already.
Kai. Na video si cheap.
Yeah, tulikuwa tumefanya video tayari. Uh-huh. And then we had to reshoot. Unajua kuna vitu mob watu wana feel kuhusu music yetu.
Mm-hmm.
And I took taka kujiweka kwa hiyo place. Ya kuanza ku explain.
Mm-hmm.
Unajua.
Yeah.
So tukaamua since we are not in that space and everyone is jumping on that ka issue, wengine wana toa video za watu wako Illuminati, wanaruka na makesi. Wengine wanasema zwi dini, wengine hao ndio wana forgive. Yani kukakua, hiyo kitu ni kama
Anita ni wakubashu
watu. Yeah. So ikakua ni kama, sasa ndio wasaniwa. Katua pia kuna kolabu nyingine pia ilitoka.
Mm-hmm.
So ikawa ni kama, itaonekana ni kama, sasa sisi wote tunataka kumaximize on hiyo kitu ilikuwa inaendelea, which is not a good thing. Mm-hmm. Kwa sababu ni vitu mob zime happen hapo, zile watu wanahitaji ni issue ambayo inahitaji ku handle with a lot of wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
Na watu wapate solution poa.
Yeah.
So tukaona badala pia si tujiingishe kwa hiyo confusion na nini na maswali, wacha tu reshoot.
Okay.
Wacha tu reshoot. So we reshoot the video. Of course tulikuwa na clips zingine za hiyo place, so tuliongeza tu and then we released the video.
I quick one, I would love to make this is very clear. People remember I was very vocal. Mm-hmm. About the whole DK and Wicked thing. I was very vocal about it because I don't like people sweeping things under the rug. That's not who we are as a nation. And when you decided to do the song, it's called Mercy.
Yeah.
And maybe people haven't heard it. I've listened to the whole song a couple of times.
Mm-hmm.
You're talking about got to have mercy on you, maybe as a nation, as a generation. You're speaking on behalf of a generation.
Mm-hmm.
Is it that you felt people are going the wrong way? Why? Because that song is deep. Okay, most of the songs are deep, but this song is specifically talking for a whole generation. Were you apologizing on behalf of Akina DK?
No, really Akina DK, because I mentioned watu kadha.
Nikitoa list hapa, tutahama.
Yeah, thing is, sisi wote tumepotea, unajua? Na ile kitu inaonyesha kwamba tumepotea. A while back, some years back when I started music, kulikuwa na gospel industry.
Mm-hmm.
Kina Daddy Owen.
Yes.
O kulikuwepo kina Eunice Njeri, kulikuwepo Emikos Gay, kulikuwa na hiyo generation. Esther Wahome.
Yeah.
No one ever asked.
Mm-hmm.
When kina Owen released a song, no one ever asked kama your song ni gospel kweli. Unajua?
They knew.
Wewe unasikia unajua hii ni gospel. Ukisikia ni wimbo ya mtu fulani, you already know it's a gospel song. But right now your swali ipo sana.
Oh yes, it is there.
Your swali ipo sana. So hiyo ni kuonesha kwamba clearly,
mm-hmm,
us guys have lost it. We have lost it.
Mm-hmm.
And it is in the eyes of everyone who is listening to us, because one thing about music is that the music from the heart goes to the heart. So if it's a spiritual song, it will minister to someone. You don't need to push it. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So when a song fails to minister, then it means kuna kitu haiko kwa hiyo song.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So tumepotea kwa sababu so many people are complaining. Hata utaona tweets on social media and everyone who's talking about gospel, hakuna mtu wako na kitu poa ya kusema about the gospel industry.
Mm-hmm.
Which is very sad. Kwa sababu wakati tulianza sisi wote tulianza na roho sana.
Mm-hmm.
Tulianza na roho na huruma, wazazi wangu walikufa. Yaani tulianza tumenyenyekea kabisa. Sisi ni watu, unajua?
Are you more angry than me? Yeah.
No. And then suddenly it turned into just something else. You cannot even, yani how understand that I can comfortably do a song with a secular artist and tell you people that God is the one who has sent me. You know, God is not an author of confusion. Come on. You know, if God is the one who has sent you, that song will minister.
That's
understand?
True.
So, kila mtu akianza kukubash about that song that God amekutuma. Kwani God amekutuma watu wakubash? Because God anajua ile reaction itakuwa. Ama God anajua kitu hiyo song itadu before we kupatie. Understand? So, God haezi kukutuma mahali itakumez. Understand? So, vitu zikabadilika, alafu mtu alisema kwamba patia mtu pesa, alafu utajua true color zake.
No, actually, Gadia, let me correct you. Money does not bring out your character. It actually unlocks the characters that were dealt by poverty. Mm-hmm. That was said somewhere the other day and I laughed. But it's true. Mm-hmm. But wengi, they are who they are because they don't have money.
It's true.
They are humble, they're quiet, they are locked.
Kesha, makesha.
Hey, what a worship. Watu Yesu ni Bwana.
Aya, mbaya sana.
Lakini akiambona watu watano yeye ni celebrity.
Kushangaa.
Na mademo amfollow Instagram.
Kushangaa.
Na akuwa hot shot.
Kushangaa.
Na weke nywele dye.
Sasa vitu zimebadilika mazee.
Na atafute tatu mbili tu. Na tatu itaandikwa Jesus is Lord na kwaje kwa cross. It's a rap, it's been real.
Vitu zimechange. Mtu sasa amekuwa ni yeye kabisa kabisa. It's about him, it's about PR, it's about how many people are talking about me. Whether they are talking about me in all the wrong reasons, they don't care about that. We don't care about God anymore. We don't care about how will people feel about, how about those people who are following me for the sake of the body of Christ? You understand? How about those people wenye anaona na kitu nafanya kila siku anaona yenyewe hii ndio kitu nataka kufuata kwa sababu even though God and bless him say because how it's printed and how it is clearly it's that if you follow God this is how he's going to bless you. So if God has blessed you to the extent where you turn against him then kila mtu atafeel wale wanatufuata watafeel unajua mimi sasa nikitokea na kimdem tuko uchi huko sijui wapi wale watu wote wananifuata wanataka kuokoka wanasema hivi ndio njia.
It's true.
You understand? So sometimes even for the sake, sisi wote ni binadamu.
It's true.
Ray, mi, kuna time pia naweza kucheki hivi photo yako na sema, Ray, Mungu.
Okay, usinitumia kama
example. No, no, example. You understand? No, I'm just giving a general example. You understand? Yeah, sisi wote ni binadamu. Kuna kukulu utacheki mtu zeme, yenye hapa, God ali create fit. Asante. But for the sake of wale watu unaitu.
Wana kufollow. Yeah. Yes.
Iyo kitu jikewe mwenyewe. Kufa nayo, you understand? Mm-hmm. Hiyo photo kali yenye mazema, abs, manini. For the sake of those people. Not that it's a bad thing, kwa sababu watu wanaenda kaswimune za to. It's not a bad thing, but for the sake.
Of the people who follow you, the people who look up to you, you need to keep it.
Wale wenye God alitupatia influence kwa sababu yao. Because God hakutupea influence kwa sababu yetu. Ni kwa sababu yao. Kwamba, tuweze kuwa direct. Yani sisi kwamba tumekuwa kio.
Why ni kio to
tell you that? Maze. Alafu na sasa hiyo kio unabadilisha inakuwa vitu zingine. Unamulikia watu ma vitu za ajabu ajabu. So it's si kitu mbaya. Mtu akitaka kuimba secular sawa. Wewe unaweza kuimba ukitaka kuimba love song, basi Songs of Solomon ipo nini? Yaani love ziko nini? Unaweza kuifanya. Ni kitu fit, ni song wewe ni msanii. But for the sake of wale watu God alikupea. Wale wasio na feel kwamba sasa hawana mtu wa kufuata.
Wanakufuata wewe. Well, today I feel like we have a whole new generation someone in. Because, you know, the problem with our generation are to pay you queen. And I'm telling you this from sitting in a position where I know people don't want to be told the truth because the truth hurts. Mm. And we are a generation of likes and followers and trends.
Yeah.
If you're not making those hits, then you're not a big artist, you're not a celebrity.
Yeah.
And we are the problem because that's what we make people to be. Anyway, join this discussion on the hashtag 186 Drive. All right, it's quite a lot of discussion. To remember, come away, you say you are gospel. Wewe, say you touch a dinner, vangu, kipiga picha. Brave, acha kutuambia 10 over 10. I owe you my 10. PSC tuko na 11 over 11 people. We're not posting them everywhere. Kwanza, the best part of today's interview. Mlianza mkilia, sina mama, sina wazazi wa hala. Wewe, I'm going to go back to the same question. This song, what do you want to achieve with this song?
I didn't even want to achieve something with it. I just wanted us to. Unajua kuna ile time yenye kuna kuangana ka call. Mazee, wasee, kumbukeni bana. Eh, wasee. Ni kunoma bana, tuna lost bana. You understand? So the only way to call people out is through a song. You understand? Because I wouldn't go on social media also and record a video telling people, oh guys, you need. So I thought, instead of talking to people, let me talk to God. Because God ndo ametuweka hii place yenye tuko. All of us guys, and God is seeing all this stuff. And one thing we didn't stop to think, how does God feel about everything that is happening? understand? Because it got to a place now where it's all about us guys, you know, eh, waso wangapi wame like, eh, hey, waso wangapi wame view, you understand?
How many views on
Instagram? Eh, maze, hata it's not even about the souls anymore, bana. Na zi ndo waze, wa gospel wenye, eh, tunafaa kuwa more concerned na souls za wase.
Because
hiyo ndo ministry, you understand? More concerned na how many people have been impacted by the song.
Yeah.
How many people have been impacted by the message. How many people have listened to the message and felt maze, na nidee, na nidukurudi, ama na nidukufanya hivi, na hivi, na hivi, you understand?
Because
hii tuko tu ma-views. Ma-views, oh, ma-likes, oh, ma-followers, badini. So it's just about sisi, and you know, selfish interest, vitu za ufala maze, vitu wada hazi make sense, you understand? So even go to places where sasa kuna to fight, some of us even create the dream of vitu mama stands, vitu za kifala inachosha bana, understand? So me, I go to a place where nilifeel wacha nisionge na watu, because sisi wote tuko hapo, I can't judge, maybe mimi niko na, pia mimi weakness yangu, different. But zote ni weakness, you understand? Yes. Zote mbele ya God ni sin.
Because
kuna msi ame sin, maybe na ame ako sexually immoral. Mi ni kuna unforgiveness, na iyo unforgiveness I've really actually been struggling with it. Yani mi unanikosea mazena, na mwana ni kuforgive inakata. It's also sin. So all of us guys are here, unajua. So mi my prayer was, yani wase wasikize song, wakumbuke enyewe kuna mahali tulianzia. You understand? So even as we ask God to forgive us, mtu akisikia song ataenda pia yeye kwa place yake personal na God amwambie, eh, maze kwa sababu ya hii na hii na hii, ni forgive.
Come on, pull up that song again. I want you to listen to this song, by the way, and you can find it on YouTube. It is massive. When the first time I heard this song, actually it's from me on YouTube. And people don't know this, I'm a sucker for gospel music. Good gospel music, let me clarify. And my beef with gospel artists is not anything else other than the fact that they don't preach what they drink. You're preaching? I'm preaching water and drinking wine. I don't believe in that. I believe you should be who you are. Mimi na kwa garitare, nitoke hapa, niende kanisa, niende mentorship. I am me. I can't change. I cannot even change for anything in this world. So if you're a gospel artist, can you please be yourself all the time, 24/7? Let's not confuse people. And Guardian Angel, let me ask you quite a different question. If you would fix the gospel industry today, where would you start? What would you do?
What happened when us guys came into the industry, the generation that it has not left, but it's still there, but sasa hiyo yenye ambayo imekuja before us. But what happened when we came in is there was a wave. There was a wave for gospel. You understand? Anything that we may mention, you are Jesus ndani, ni gospel in a hit. So hiyo wave, hiyo grace ilikuwepo. Watu walikuwa na feel kwamba gospel iko na mado, unajua? Gospel iko everywhere, yeah. So the people came into the gospel not necessarily because you're born again, but because indo iko na do.
You
understand?
It's a money thing.
Yeah, so watu waliingia ndani na ufala yote bila hata kujua, you don't even know about God, you cannot even pray because ume mention God, you're now a gospel artist. So how on the pretty podium? So if we had to fix, we have to go back to a place where we have a relationship with God. I cannot say anything about you
if you don't know me.
If I do not know you, you understand? So everything that we say about God and we do not know him, tunadanganya. We don't have that experience. He's not that friend of ours. And that's why after tumeambia watu kumuhusu, tukienda kando kando tunafanya vitu zinambo. Why? Because yes, ubeshte yetu hata tunaifunikia tu nile ubeshte ya yeah, kuleta mbele ya watu, you understand?
It's pretend.
Yeah, so what we need to do is to go back to that place, that first place. Kwanza tujue God. To get back to the first love. Alafu, ikwe, we get to a place where we can even listen to God and ask him, which song now do I sing to people? My friend, God akikupatia song ya kuimbia wase, hautaipush kwa mtu yoyote. Hautaipost anywhere. Kweli Instagram ilikuwepo wakati kina Mary Atieno wana hit. wale jamaa wa kitambo hawakuwa na social media na songs zao zilikuwa big, zilikuwa zinafika mbali maocha huko, mkoocha huko mnasikia songs zao. Why? Because hizo ni song God has inspired. It's inspired by the Holy Spirit. So if we can get back to a place again where we can receive from the word of God, hapo itakuwa sawa. Na hiyo tu ni kurudi, watu warudi kwa magoti, wasome wadu, waingie makanisa, watafute Mungu, wapate Mungu, tujue tuko na Mungu. Alafu sasa from there we can start singing to you people.
Now there's a song I was requested to hear. I had said I don't know if you can play it, it's a Friday. I'm gonna play this one. This is my dedication to you because you're taking up a battle that is not easy, first of all. Mm-hmm. But it's as you said, if a battle comes from the heart, I always tell people you have to do something from your heart, because if it's not from your heart, then it cannot work. Mm-hmm. You cannot force anything. Mm-hmm. That's the biggest war we ever have. Not even in Kenya, I'm in our gospel industry, in the entire world, in politics, in life. Fighting for the truth is the biggest and the most difficult war you ever fight, because people don't like the truth. Even I don't like the truth. Who likes the truth? Nobody wants to be told the truth. You only like telling the truth, mm-hmm, to other people. Mm-hmm. And your last words, Daddy, there's someone, so many questions about how you've, so many questions. Wendy, Nangata, Papa, Papa, all the way, Akiwa, Mombasa, I can see we have his, literally, everybody has the same question. Dickie Muremi, I can see you saying your songs minister to him, but you are the same. Thank you so much, guys. The hashtag is on 96 Drive. And they're asking the same question. In the middle of all this madness, how do you maintain sanity?
Because this thing is not about us. Sanity and discipline and faith and everything is not about us. It's something that God gives by the grace. But one good thing about all these things is nikitu wanga unaamua unataka kufanya. Because if I have to call a girl, nyumba yangu nitachukua simu, ningia phone book, nitafute namba yake, call. Unajua, hizi ni vitu zote nimepanga nifanye.
Mpe direction.
Nimpe direction. Mali atafika nimchukue. Mm-hmm. So hiyo ni kitu nimeamua kufanya. Mm-hmm. Je, nikiamua nisimcall.
Just for choice.
So ni choice, you understand? Mm-hmm. So this is something you choose to do. Ni life yako umeshika hivi kwa mkono yako, unasema hapa nitaiweka kwa dustbin, ama nitaiweka in the right place. It's a choice. Biblia inasema kwamba Mungu hawezi kukuacha uko tempted beyond your capability to resist. Okay, you understand? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So again, as much as sisi ni binadamu na tuko na mwili, ni kuomba God every day kwamba atusaidie kusimama, atupatie grace. But some of these things unaamua tu wewe mwenyewe, ni kitu unaamua kwamba sasa hivi ndio nataka kufanya. Also, me, I think my relationship with God ni kitu iko tight, viril, because I'm looking at where God has gotten me from. Mm-hmm. And like I said, tukianza tulikuwa na hizo kilio za uongo za wazazi na nini, mali nimelelewa hizo uongo zote mapia hizo, mm-hmm, hiyo ndio ilitumesa mpaka tukasahau relationship yetu ya ukweli na God ni gani. Eh, unaona? Mm-hmm. So mimi na hiyo ndio kitu wa gazi sahau manze. God ameitwa street, kama street boy huko, nikateseka na madhangu, nikashikwa, nikaenda sell. Hiyo yote kwa sababu alitaka kumake kitu kwa life yangu.
Yeah.
So lazima hiyo kitu anataka kufanya kwa life yangu iwe accomplished. Before ifanyike, mazee siwezi afford hata kuanza kucheza cheza.
Okay. Thank you so much for coming.
Appreciate.
We're gonna keep telling people to feel mercy. To have mercy on themselves also, as they're asking God to have mercy on them. And continue doing what you do, Garden. As you said, if you're doing the right thing, you don't need to push it, you don't need to ask anyone. God's timing is everything, and God has his plans. I have to keep anger at the end of the day. Kame amua, badu unakula haso, hii muta, unakula haso.
Ambalami.
Thank you so much for coming, and have an amazing, amazing kid, Garden. I hope to see more of you. What do you expect with it? Just for, you have 30 seconds, what should be expected in 2019?
2019, let's just think about God. I'm going to sing a lot about God, because the Bible says you cannot please God without faith. You get faith by listening and listening to the word of God. So I'm going to just do that, because that's the assignment God has given us, to tell people and tell them more about God. So us guys will be releasing songs every month. Paka mwaka ishe yani.
All about God. Now you know what 2018 is going to be about.
Join the world of Viusasa Entertainment and enjoy the videos you love. SMS the word Viusasa to 40